that time. You used to play, or we used to go all the way to the Rudy Pasta House in East LA.
Right, Rudy Pasta. Right, yes, yes.
I mentioned to you a lot of things, then probably you're going to remember. We was to, Mark asking to you, Sancho Loco asking to you, Ralphie Pagan. Ralphie Pagan passed away in 1979.
Right, there you go. Okay.
Yeah, in 1979, he went to Colombia, and he...
Right.
He, I don't know what kind of trick his lawyer made to him. Yes, I know. I know the truth. And Ralphie Pagan, they find his body in the beach of Colombia.
Right, that's true, because when I went to Colombia in 94, I saw the newspaper article, and they had him, he was in the street, or wherever you said, in the ditch.
Yeah, in the beach.
And, yeah, so the guy was explaining to me, but I really never got the full story.
Yeah, so you're hearing it here first on the Sancho Loco Show. This is news that maybe you didn't know, and maybe you weren't expecting that Victor's here, but I was talking to Victor today, and I was like, hey, you know, Joe's going to call in. And he's like, Joe Batan? I said, yeah. He goes, you know what? I remember Joe. And I said, I wonder if Joe remembers you.
You came from you came from Fania Records, and you
That's
know
right.
Jerry Masucci and Johnny Pacheco. They support me in KMAX in the radio station. Now that remember something to you?
Yes,
K-Max.
Yes. KMAX. Yes. KMAX. I came up there later.
Okay, then that's what happened. And from that time on, we keep doing radio, a lot of different things, and everything is fine.
I hear you. Yes, yes, yes. That brings back a lot of memories. Yes.
You know, I give you the name to Ralphie, El Flaco de Oro. I'm the one put that name.
Right.
I put that name to him, and from that day, then I say you are the Flaco de Oro, because I did it in the TV when we used to record in International Clock in East LA too.
Right, because Ralphie lived there in LA.
Yes.
And I remember that story about his lawyer.
From that time,
his brother told me.
Ralphie Pagan have a lot of people listen to you. Do you remember Symphony C in New York?
Yes, Symphony C, Dick Ricardo Sugar, yes. I remember Tony Salazar in California, one of the first to play my records. We had a lot of college stations back then, because California had the biggest, largest radio stations in the United States as far as public radio. And the public radio was the first ones to give us our story at KPFK, a lot of those stations, and Tony was one of the first.
Well, I understand Chico Sesma used to play your music too a lot.
That's right. Chico did, yes. Good friend of my friend, Chico Manqueros, yeah. Yes.
When you gonna come?
We gotta visit you, Joe. When are you gonna be down here again?
Well, the first time I'm coming is March 23rd and March 24th at Stevens Steakhouse. That's at Commerce, California. Then I'll be coming back in July 14th to the Greek Theater. And then after that, I think Cinco de Mayo, I'll be in the Cow Palace in San Francisco.
All right, we're going to go check you out when you're in Commerce. I'm going to talk to, is it Roy?
Steven Steakhouse. Right.
Yeah, so.
In City Commerce.
Ray Carrion's birthday.
Ray Carrion, yeah. I talked to him earlier, so I'm gonna link up with Ray, and, man, we're going to go visit you, and maybe you and Victor can chop it up then, man. But I'm super excited that you called in today. I'm going to be playing your music for the rest of the day, man. And any new music you coming out with?
Well, you got to come there on March 23rd and 24th. Now I'll be previewing some of my new stuff.
Oh, man.
What I'm going to be doing.
We'll get the exclusive. Everybody that's tuning in, make sure you go check them out at the Steakhouse. Hey, man, I want to thank you, Joe, for calling in, man.
Thank you. And Victor, Mark. God bless you, and
que
viva la raza.
Viva la raza.
Arriba la raza.
All right, man. Thank you, Joe.
Okay.
Have a good one, man.
Thank you. Bye.
All right. You heard it here first on the Sancho Loco Show. Man, Victor, that's an old friend of yours.
Oh, yes. We're talking about 1979.
And how did you meet Joe?
Because I used to represent Fania Records here in California.
Okay, you represented Fania Records. And Fania Records, that's the label that Joe was signed to.
Fania Records was the... Ralphie Pagan belonged to Fania.
Yeah.
Willie Colon belonged to Fania. Ray Barreto belonged to Fania. Johnny Pacheco.
And you were on the radio at that time.
Yes. And Fania Records, they paid me. That's no payola.
Payola in English, what is that?
Payola is when you get money for playing the music.
Like greasing the palm.
Yes, you're going to collect money because you're going to play the music.
Like blackmailing.
That's right.
It's illegal, man.
That's illegal.
What were you doing illegal stuff at that time?
No.
I'm just kidding.
I was promoting Fania Record here.
Oh, man.
The telephone.
I think Joe hung up on us.
No. Yeah. No, he say bye.
No, I'm playing. I'm playing, Joe. Thank you for calling, Joe.
Then, you know, and I promoting Fania here. I played the music for Fania Record. I met in person Jerry Masucci, who was the owner, in partnership with Johnny Pacheco.
So do you know Rafi Pagan too?
Hey, I'm the one that put his name, El Flaco de Oro.
Did
he used to come to my apartment?
Flaco de Oro means skinny guy of gold.
That's right.
Okay.
Yeah, because Rafi Pagan was really skinny.
He was a skinny man.
Oh,
so really he passed away in 1980.
Huh?
Ralphie Pagan passed away in 1980.
1975. At the end of 1975.
Wow, I was just a little...
79. I'm sorry, 79.
Okay. Yeah, I was a little kid back then. So.
But he, let me tell you, those people in East LA, in New York, the Chicano. Oh,
yeah, they love him.
They love him.
All of Chicano people love
They
Joe
remember
Batang.
Joe Batang and Ralphie Pagan.
Yeah, the two classic guys in the industry. That every car show to this day they still play both of those people's music. Even young people know both of those names.
Oh yes, you know, Ralphie Pagan have something. Then his voice was something so lyric, and the voice was really something that you can enjoy.
Did you know that Joe Batang was Filipino and African American?
Joe Batang, I don't know that
part. Yeah, yeah.
I know him when I came from New York. I used to listen the promotion. They used to have a nightclub the Monday night. They only they open Monday night, and the advertising they say, "Decay, Monday night, Joe Batang present." Wow, terrible, something great.
And when they did shows in New York, was it like at a disco place or where was it at?
Different nightclub.
Yeah, just like normal, like here.
Yes.
But okay.
It was like a big group. They one day they're going to the gate. Another day they're going to the Cheetah. Cheetah was something big over there in New York too.
Oh, wow.
Ralphie Mercado was the guy that promote all those kind of music there.
Did you ever go to Studio 54?
No, because I was here in California at that time.
Oh, at that time you were here
in
California.
Yes, I was here in California.
All right. Well, you guys heard it here first. Thank you for being my guest on my show, Victor. I know that you have your own show. Listen to Victor in the morning. It was great letting you guys listen to Joe Batang call in, and then Victor and him shared a little moment, and we're going to go see him in March, right?
Okay. Okay.
Okay. In March, we're going to go see Joe play, and then we'll link up. We'll keep you guys posted. Sancho Loco Show.